اموت وياك حب قلوبنا وانت ولينا شيعتك بايعنا نحيا ونموت وياك حب قلوبنا وانت
علي بن أبي طالب صلوات الله وسلامه عليه was born on the 13th of Rajab in the year 600 and died on the 21st of Ramadan in the 40th year after Hijrah. He occupies a prominent position within the religion of Islam as being revered as one of the greatest leaders in Islamic history. A man from whose life many extraordinary lessons may be learnt. And many examples may be derived. And a man who was seen as the embodiment of knowledge, generosity, valor and bravery, as well as dedication towards the religion of Islam. An honor in Islamic history only reserved for Ali ibn Abi Talib. That he is the only man in Islamic history to be born in the Kaaba. You will find that there are some other historical references to other people being born in the Kaaba. But this was a group of people who tried to diminish from the prestige of Ali ibn Abi Talib. The only man in history to be born in the Kaaba, to be born in that black cube that you find in Mecca, was Ali. And that's why you find when his mother emerged from the Kaaba on the fourth day, the first person to welcome her was the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. The Prophet welcomed her, he took Ali from her hands, and the Imam himself would narrate that from that day, throughout his childhood, the Prophet would embrace Ali.
Ali is the gem that is unlike any other. Amir al-Mu'mineen. وسيد الوصيين وإمام المتقين ويعسوب المسلمين أمير المؤمنين أسد الله الغالب علي بن أبي طالب is a truly unique character because he's the only person in history who's been able to combine and bring together all these antithetical qualities in the same human being. He is the one who is seen weeping and sobbing and crying in the middle of the night, calling out, Mawlaya, Mawlaya, Anta al-Sayyid wa ana al-Abd, wa hal yarham al-Abd illa al-Sayyid. In the famous supplication of Amir al-Mu'mineen, read it, brothers and sisters. Read this supplication. You'll be reminded of just how great a personality Ali ibn Abi Talib was. These words are originating from the mouth of a man who is the bravest on the battlefield, who is the most ferocious in the face of the enemies of God, who is the greatest commander of any army. This is the same man who smashed open the gate of Khaybar single-handedly. Ali ibn Abi Talib is the one who does not tolerate oppression. Ali ibn Abi Talib, who was so sensitive about the way the treasury is handled. Not a single dime is taken from it unjustly under his watchful eyes. We could go on and on for years, and by God we'll never be able to do justice to the justice of Ali. Why is Ali ibn Abi Talib so special? Because he was the first to submit to the religion of Allah. Ali ibn Abi Talib was the first to come to Rasulullah whenever he needed help. He was always the first to respond to Rasulullah. Amir al-Mu'mineen was always the first to stand in the battlefield while everyone fled for their lives. Ali ibn Abi Talib is this great man whose name we will call for our entire lives. When you want to get up, you say, Ya Ali. When you want to sit down, you say, Ya Ali. When you want to climb a bunch of stairs, you say, Ya Ali. When you want to help your kids ride a bicycle, you teach them to say, Ya Ali. When your mother's giving birth to you at the hospital, she calls out, Ya Ali. Why? Because Rasulullah always called out, Ya Ali. Ya Ali. Ya Ali.
Ya Ali. Ya Ali. Ya Ali. Ya Ali. Nadi Ali. مجليا مظهر العجائب تجده عونا لك في النوائب نادي عليا مظهر العجائب تجده عونا لك في النوائب كل هم وغم سينجلي بولايتك يا علي يا علي كل هم وغم سينجلي بولايتك يا علي يا علي
أولا يا مولاي أنت المولى وأنا العبد وهل يرحم العبد إلا المولى.
In history, there is only one man in history that gave zakat in the state of ruku, and that is Imam Ali ibn Abi Talib alayhi salatu wassalam. His status is so elevated that he has enraged the enemies. His wisdom was beyond comprehension. When you ask me such question, when he says, Saluni, Saluni, قبل أن تفقدوني, ask me before you miss me. Why did he say that? Because he has already been endowed with this wisdom. He has been endowed with this knowledge for you and I to follow. He's just not a man of wisdom. He's a man of action. You and I, brothers and sisters, should be Muslims of action. The Imam, the name of Ali ibn Abi Talib is Sha'air Allah, is Dhikr. Dhikr Allah. To mention the name of Imam Ali is Dhikr of Allah, because when you look at him, he does nothing but takes you to Allah. He never takes you to himself. He never says, worship me. He never says, how great I am. He never does any of that. He keeps taking us to the Prophet and Allah. So why should he not be remembered? Why should we not remember him? Why should we not mention him? Why should we not live like him?